down in the city, back of my neck getting dirt and gritty. Bend down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match here. But at night it's a different world. Go out and find a girl. Come on and dance all night. Despite the heat, it'll be alright. And babe, don't you know it's a pity the days can't be like the nights in the summer in the city.
Hello and welcome to Summer in the City, the show where we give you the best things to do over summer in your nearest city. I'm your host, Jamie Tanner.
And I'm Kelly Banlacky. This week we're in Manchester, showing you how to get ready for summer in this great city. On today's show, we've got the latest fashions for you, we've gone round and found some great quirky cafes, and we've got some information about all the music events and festivals you could possibly want. Also, make sure you tweet us throughout the show with the hashtag Summer in the City.
But first, Adam Manning went down to the best beer gardens in Manchester, and we've compiled the top five for you now.
As the summer draws closer and the days get longer, we wanted to give you the countdown of the best beer gardens in Manchester. Starting with number five, Dockyard at Media City. Looking out over a wide open plaza, Dockyard offers quality food and quirky decor. Along with that, there is also the opportunity to look out at all the celebrities wandering around and taking a break. Number four is in fact another Dockyard, however this one is situated over Spinfields, looking out over the canal. Facing west of a bustling atmosphere, the Dockyard will be sure to get you making the most of the late morning lunch. At number three, you voted for Oast House, the quaint and rustic feel. Oast House is on the cusp of the avenue in the ever-bustling Spinfields district. And with a pavilion-style roof, Oast House will keep you dry and refreshed whilst out in Manchester. Number two, we've got Duke's 92, Castlefield's original summer bar and grill, has a picturesque surrounding even if a little out of the way. Duke's is still the spot to enjoy the spring sunshine, situated in the heart of Castlefield overlooking the Bridgewater Canal. Finally, voted at number one, you voted for Sinclair's Oyster Bar. It's the go-to place and first sign of the sun in the city centre. It's perfect for a mid-stop break.
And now here's Chloe with all the latest fashion and this season's hottest trends.
Okay, today we're going to show you four easy to recreate and affordable looks on four of our fabulous models. First up, we've got Amelia showing us how to do 70s Woodstock. The top is £5.99 H&M, the trousers £24.99 also from H&M, and the boots £34 from Zara.
Oh, absolutely fantastic, Amelia. How do you feel on it?
I love it because it's not something I usually wear, so it'll be a nice change to my wardrobe.
Brilliant, superb.
Next up, we've got Carl looking super suave in his turtleneck, carrying on that 70s vibe. The turtleneck is £29.99 from Zara, and the Cheap Monday trousers are from Urban Outfitters at £44.99. This look is perfect for like going from bar to bar. He looks super smart, he's bang on trend, and it looks smart for going out with the boys, night out, that kind of thing.
Great stuff. Carl looking very dapper.
Thank you, yeah, I really like it. I feel comfortable in it, and it's a new look for me.
Fantastic, excellent.
Bob, thank you, Carl. Next up, we've got a couple more really relaxed, chilled out looks. Think beach parties in Ibiza, festivals, that kind of thing. First up, we've got Vinny. He is wearing the new Puma Arrow Black, £60 from size. The jeans are £20 from Bershka. The t-shirt is £15 from Topman. And his five panel cap is from online retailer Flatspot. And that was just £25. That's a Nike one there. How do you feel, Vin?
Yeah, something I can see myself wearing when I go to festivals in the summer.
Yeah, brilliant. Heartlife, see you wearing that there. Next up, we've got Grace. The top is £8 from Primark. The metallic skirt is £24 from American Apparel. The shirt was a fab vintage find. The rucksack, bargain at £7 from H&M. And the trainers, a little bit pricey. The New Balance, £85, also from size, but they'll carry you through all summer long, and if the weather's not great, girls, festival, stick a pair of wellies on, Doc Martens, it'll carry you through. Perfect.
Grace, looking fantastic. How are you feeling?
I really like it. I think that this is an outfit I could see myself wearing in the future.
Brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. Thanks. So, ladies and gents, what's your favourite outfit? Come with you first.
I think my favourite was the last one. I like the use of metallic colours, and I could see myself wearing it on a night out.
Oh, fantastic. And yourself, sir?
I think the festival goer outfit was really good. I really liked the use of the nightcap. I thought it was absolutely brilliant.
Excellent. Superb. Well, back to you, Kelly.
And now, we scoured Manchester to find the fun and quirky places for you to eat, and we came across a very interesting place. Black Milk is a cereal bar. That's right, serving a vast array of cereal from all around the globe, from the US to Europe to Israel, Black Milk will be sure to satisfy your cereal craving.
The base of the actual cafe is obviously within the name, it's Black Milk, so you can actually create your own little milks and everything. So we've obviously got all your caramel, vanillas, hazelnuts, and then all your chocolate, vanilla, strawberry, but you can mix and match them together as well. So then yeah, you've got all your cereal selections. I've got cereals from all around the world, America, Israel, Holland, obviously UK, and then all the other places as well. The idea came from a place in New York actually, who's some milk bar as well, so like a kind of a breakfast milk bar. So that's where we got the idea from, and then yeah, then obviously the space came up in Afflex, and we thought it was the perfect place to start off with it. So
would you come back here again?
Yeah, we'd come back, yeah. I think we all really liked it. It was something different, and there's so many different like options that you can have, so you can come back and try something different again next time.
Looks absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, it does, really does. So, we've taken a look at the best festivals available to you in Manchester this summer.
So, the first festival coming up this season is the Dot to Dot. This unique festival takes place on May Bank Holiday and tickets are only £25. Like the name suggests, you go from venue to venue, places such as Soup Kitchen, Mint Lounge, Cord and Roadhouse, and give it a chilled vibe with bands such as Ray Morris, St. Raymond and Swim Deep playing.
Next up, for all the cowboys and girls out there, Grill Stock offers country music and barbecue food, bringing the American Southwest to Manchester on the 30th and 31st of May.
Now, last week we asked you to send in your favourite festival photos, so here they are.
The next first weekend of June and is located in Heaton Park. Of course, we're talking about park life. This festival is really popular with students and young people in Manchester with its house music. This year's headliners include Disclosure, Rudimental and Ben Howard, and a range of all-star DJs like Richie Horton, Annie Mac and Hannah Wants. And don't forget the Park Life official after party at the Parkside Hotel on Bury Old Road.
For those who enjoy the swaying of the saxophone, the Manchester Jazz Festival is for you. The 9-day-long festival in the city centre is from the 13th to the 21st of July. All the information of the lineup was released yesterday, so we recommend you check it out.
Well, that's it for this week, but be sure to join us next week when we will be heading to the culture capital, that is Liverpool.
But first, before we leave, we have one more treat. Play us out with a cover of the Libertines' Don't Look Back Into the Sun. We've got local musician Rory Moses.
They won't let you go.